Nasze wizje o kolei, czyli Kolejwizja, Tomasz Dasuj oraz Herman Schmittendorf. Witamy Państwa serdecznie.
3 years ago, the British company Arriva entered Polish rail market, being the first private-owned operator in passenger service. Today we present Arriva's diesel trains of MR and MRD class and we show what had to be done in order to bring them into service on Polish rail.
May 24, 2007. An uncommon train arrived at the Polish-German border station of Guben. A German Arriva-owned diesel locomotive carried DMU number 68 of MR-MRD class. The train set was taken over by a diesel locomotive of Polish rail operator PCC Rail, who took it to Poznan-based Rail Vehicle Institute IPS. In 2007, a joint venture of Arriva and PCC had won a tender, becoming the first private-owned rail operator in Poland to provide regular passenger trains at Kujawsko-Pomorskie Voivodeship. It was decided that MR-MRD DMUs should carry out that service. The train sets had been built between 1978 and 1982 at German Duwag Uerdingen Company and had been operated ever since by Danish State Railway DSB. In order to run them on Polish rail lines, they had to pass homologation procedure at Poland's Rail Transportation Office UTK and gain the so-called Certificate of Vehicle Type. Therefore, MR-MRD DMU of number 68 served Poznan specialists as prototype to undertake necessary examinations and technical modifications. Detailed technical documentation, including operation and revision manuals, also had to be written.
Przygotowanie pojazdów szynowych do pierwszego w Polsce prywatnego ruchu osobowego.
Preparing a rail vehicle for Poland's first private passenger rail service is an exciting challenge. This vehicle had been manufactured in Germany and came to Poland after heavy repair work done in Denmark and Germany. It will now be checked at Poznan's Rail Research Institute in order to run in Poland.
Przygotowany do użytkowania na polskich torach.
Podstawowy zakres prób polegał będzie na sprawdzeniu układów hamulcowych.
Basic tests will include brake examinations, strength tests of vehicle and bogie frames, and examinations connected to traveling comfort. Braking tests will be executed with maximum load and maximum speeds. They are some of the most essential tests to pass a vehicle for operation on Polish rail.
PKP i w rejonie jednym z okręgów polskich.
Homologation certificate is issued by Rail Transportation Office at Warsaw, based on examinations and opinions of an approved rail institute. Our rail institute is such an approved institution. Existing already test results are some 20 years old and come from outside of Poland. In order to be sure that the vehicle is safe, such tests have to be renewed.
Bezpiecznie będzie przewoziło pasażerów, trzeba takie testy ponowić. Pojazd ten jest pojazdem drugiej kategorii i testy, które będziemy...
All tests to be undertaken now were the brake tests, strength tests or noise tests are effected according to the same criteria as for a completely new rail vehicle, without any exception.
Nie ma żadnej taryfy ulgowej.
One of the basic demands is to examine all non-metal elements on fire resistance. All such components also have to pass examinations under the focus of formation of smoke and chemical gas. Old curtains had been exchanged at once against new ones with certificate, lamp covers at passenger compartments as well. Several components of passenger seats did not pass rigid examinations. A Polish specialized rail upholstery factory renewed seats to match actual fire retardancy norms without losing traveling comfort. External lighting also had to be modified. Old lamps proved to shine too low to approve to current rail law. It took detailed evaluation to find lamps that would fit actual standards as well as aesthetic demands. In order to carry out strength tests, the two train set carriages had to be separated. One of the units was examined at a special pressure test stand. Special knowledge is inevitable to join both train set units. Therefore, Danish DSB rail specialists were invited to Poznan in order to supervise work. In the meantime, drivers' cabins were supplied with rail communication and safety devices. Internal and external Danish lettering and writing was exchanged against labels in Polish. Both trains said carriages have been joined again. Jürgen from Denmark and Holger and Frank from Germany, however, keep on working. Pneumatic and electronic schemes passed over from Denmark need explanation and modification. The Germans are employed at Arriva Rail Repair Workshop AWN at Neustrelitz. This company had repaired the MR-MRD DMU before delivery to Poland. AWN is experienced in repairing the German equivalent class 628 and will help maintaining MRs in Poland. But of course the German and Danish versions of that DMU class are not completely identical. What is Jürgen's opinion on MR-MRD's second life in Poland?
På dansk, ja, der kan man godt sige lidt. Jeg synes, I er sluppet godt fra at male tog på den måde, som I har farven og designet, det er meget flot. Det må jeg sige. Det er super. Der er sehr schön, dass man trotzdem anwenden kan.
It is great to see that our meritorious diesel train sets have found a new home and don't have to be scrapped. There are excellent train sets with great success in Denmark and surely will be accepted as well by Polish passengers. I'm especially happy with Polish painting. You have chosen much better colors than we did in Denmark. Simply superb. With Polish colleagues we cooperate very fine. Unfortunately, I don't know any Polish, but using hands we will understand ourselves.
Des Dieselkraftstoffs, ne?
This column indicates that half of fuel is consumed, so the driver knows from experience how many miles he still may run, you know? All tests turned out to be positive, so now it's time for the first test run with Arriva PCC employees. All train components are discussed and examined in detail. This is the direction switch. Now we might start engines. First engine, second engine.
Wir hören gleich, dieses Rattern ist der Luftkompressor, ne?
Now you hear a rattling noise, that's the air compressor. Oh, it moves. So let's go. The Institute's cat escapes with fear, but for a first run with an unknown vehicle, all went fine. Before starting, of course, every day passenger service at Kujawsko-Pomorskie Voivodeship, Arriva PCC drivers had to pass serious training lessons in Poland and Denmark. On the first day of regular passenger service, the train set also stopped to emit indecent clouds of exhaust gas. Irregular smoke only appears if a diesel vehicle is stabled over months, as in our case until receiving final homologation permission at the beginning of 2008. From that time, in the opinion of passengers at Kujawsko-Pomorskie Voivodeship, MR-MRD DMUs are well accepted trains on Polish rail.
So viel zu Arriva und den MR-Dieseltriebzügen in Polen. That's it for today on Arriva and MR-Class DMUs in Poland.
To wszystko na temat firmy Arriva i pojazdów MR w Polsce. Żegnamy się z Państwem, zapraszamy ponownie. Do zobaczenia. Zmienia.